sometimes it will freak out.
It's working on default, but I'll change it back anyways.
And now it's fine.
Yep.
Because computers are weird.
Yes.
This is how they take over the world.
You know, it's funny too. The people are being like the plague that killed Yellowstone, and it's like funny how these are the people with profile pictures of them holding up deer antlers. It's like, oh, I wonder if you're biased at showing.
Nah, not at all, really.
So they killed the deer I loved. Yeah, all of these people are like pictures of like them in their hunting gear being like, wolves are a curse on society. It's like, no, you're just mad they're eating your deer.
We call that kill stealing in the Overwatch business.
I got water. Do you want me to get a freaking water?
Please.
She peed all over the ground. I'm in socks now. Shoes lace up. I ain't put them back on.
You can wear mine over there.
No. Fine. Do you want a water, too, if I'm already up for him?
Grab me one of the Powerades. They should be, like, right past the refrigerators.
Okay.
And that shall work for me. Thank you.
What kind of Powerade?
They're all the same, so pink.
Alright.
So you're the one.
Mm-hmm. If you've ever gone to that United that's on 4th of Milwaukee and wondered, hey, why the frick are there no pink ones?
They're all over at Delta's house.
Hey, I only bought 19 last time. And they had 19. They also know it's me, which makes it doubly funny. They see me walk by, they're like, oh, guess we gotta restock that now. It's the only one that I like that my dad doesn't like, because otherwise he'll drink them all. Mm. He goes through about 5 in a day otherwise. This is a boat noise, in case you're wondering why it's making this, like, weird sound effect.
I was like, where the hell are we?
Like, what's wrong with your computer?
I think you got a virus. I'd be wrong to say I wasn't swaying from side to side. I was actually shaking rather intensely. The room I was in, it was shaking from side to side. Shaking was quite irregular. Just when you thought it was a series of small shakes, would suddenly shake violently. Every time that happened, I'd have to steady myself with my foot. Can't stand up very well, but for me, it was comforting. I never thought not knowing what to expect could be so fun, so I was feeling rather excited. But I figured I'd get bored of the feeling. I'd get bored of that feeling soon enough.
of the school broadcast system. Am I on? Can everyone hear me? Okay, well then. Welcome to Hope Speak Academy, you guys. At this point, I shall explain the graduation exam to you all. So please assemble at the gymnasium immediately.
Damn right.
Yo.
What's going on?
That is...
Well, yeah. dirty bastard!
I'm gonna do it!
Hey! Damn it.
So annoying.
Jeez. Like, hey,
of course. Hey!
Even so.
However,
to default. And then back to not default.
All right.
And we'll see if it works on my end in a second.
Testing. 1, 2, 3, testing.
Blah, blah. Waffles.
I sure do do. Little USB connection noise.
Yeah.
Whoa. Ow. Oh my god. We need to turn on the mic. Jesus Christ.
Is it really loud?
We weren't even talking that loud.
Oh!
That probably heard me scream just then pretty well. Oh, and much of a scream. It's more like a startled yell. It definitely startled me.
You should probably blow out some people's speakers.
Hey, headphone users. Let's get some plastic wrap.
I heard that.
Yeah.
Well.
Granted, the volume's as high as it goes on this right now, but yeah. Still.
Is that any better?
Yeah, we'll find out in a second.
Talking, testing.
Yeah, I think we're good.
Loud. All right, cool.
You could, like, yeah, it's supposed to get lower, like, slightly more, but not, like, down to the next number that was on there. Yeah. That'll work.
There we go. That's weird. Oh, you're here again. The thing that's weird is you, of course. Huh? Why did you forget that you were part of the Reserve Department? The Future Foundation only took away your school life memories, right? But you should have known even before you entered that. Before you entered that you had no talent, right?
That was the chair, I swear.
So, I think it's weird that you actually forgot something like that, too. What do you want me to say? Based on my assumption, the Future Foundation must have wanted to hide the fact that you were one of those reserved core students. Or you willingly sealed those memories yourself.
Oh no, I just found another mystery dum-dum.
Yay.
Rip.
You wanted to be confident in yourself, so you wanted to forget everything that embarrassed you. You know, when humans experience trauma, sometimes they erase their memories of what happened. It happens pretty often. Not that I'd know anything about that myself, though. Are you saying it's my fault I forgot? That's not it. When things get inconvenient, you always get angry and try to brush it off. Well, that's expected of a Reserve Corps student.
Bye, Monokuma.
Damn it, what the heck? Damn it! Target seems pretty far away. If the production team had more time, it could have been a minigame here. Wait, what am I saying?
Break the targets!
It's a straw post. I guess that means it was used for something.
Misport the platforms.
There's a bunch of wooden lockers here. Each of them has traditional looking woodlock keys sticking out of them. I guess they're just for show. There's nothing in particular that looks like a clue. Okay, I'm assuming the clues are gonna be like obvious like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
If you can leave, it'll let you though.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh my goodness, I need to check on my poop pet. My poop pet.
Cool. It's pooping efficiently.
Okay.
You can probably clean up the poops by now. I think you're in the clear on the hope and despair meters.
Door's open.
Classroom 5A. Speaking of bad wallpapers.
At least this one's not brightly colored and annoying.
That's true.
It's not as offensive to the eyes. This is another manga. It's laying on top of the desk. This one is...
GoldenEye 006?
Manga for Mora. The Tragedy of Hope's Peak Academy. Wasn't the Tragedy of Hope's Peak Academy mentioned in that other manga too? That's why Hope's Peak Academy went bankrupt, and it was the trigger for the biggest, most tragic, most awful event in human history. If I read this manga, I will be able to learn a little more about the incident. I took the manga from the desk and started flipping through the pages to see what I could learn about the event known as the Tragedy of Hope's Peak Academy. The story made heavy use of outdated, stylized drawings depicting characters solving mysteries. What's written here is, as the manga suggests, the tragedy of Host Peak Academy occurred at Host Peak Academy. The key player in the event was a student named Izuru Kamukura. Izuru was a genius known as a symbol of hope. Host Peak Academy used all their resources to develop him. Suddenly, Izuru was a genius among geniuses and possessed various talents. Wielding superior talent for the hope of mankind, the Academy referred to Izuru as the ultimate hope. To protect such rare talent, the Academy completely concealed all evidence of Izuru's origins and identity. Because of that, most of the students at the Academy were completely unaware of Izuru's existence. But Izuru, who was known as the symbol of hope, was responsible for a horrible incident. 13 students of Host Peak Academy's student council, among the Academy's best and brightest, were brutally murdered by Izuru. However, the incident did not end there. The Academy tried to protect Izuru's superior talent and concealed the incident as though it never happened. However, a certain student began working in secret to use the incident to their advantage. That student uncovered what the Academy did, and by making that knowledge public, it stoked the fire of the Reserve Corps students. Who had long been dissatisfied with how they'd been treated, and the uprising began, and that heralded Host Peak Academy's destruction. This is the entirety of the tragedy of Host Peak Academy. Eventually, that incident would lead to the horrifying, devastating incident. The incident would be known as the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. Work cited, Danganronpa Zero.
at least they got their work cited. Yes, that's good.
With a heavy sigh, I close the manga. Am I supposed to believe this? There's no way 13 people were killed at Hope's Peak Academy.
No.
What irony! For the genius known as the Ultimate Hope to cause such a gruesome incident. A talent like that is too regal for society. It's like trying to buy a juice with a bar of gold. No! You should be lucky that you're incompetent. Damn it! He always has to lead up to something offensive. Seriously pisses me off. But Ultimate Hope. Nagito mentioned that before too, but it looks like it means something completely different here. What Nagito said was the true meaning of hope. But for Izuru, hope simply means talent. More importantly, a genius who possesses various talents. I wish they'd given me one of those talents so I didn't have to be in the reserve department. That's right, the reserve department. Here. Said that the Reserve Corps students in the Reserve Corps and Reserve Department began uprising. But what about me? Was I a participant too? No, that's not possible. There's no way. I have no reason to do something like that.
I like how it said to give me a talent, like it's Bioshock. You could just, you know, buy it out of a freaking soda machine or something.
Anyway, I've learned about the tragedy of Host Peak Academy, but the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history is a far worse incident, right? What kind of incident was it? And who are the other students that Izuru then? Who's this other student that isn't Izuru? A certain student who secretly used the incident to their advantage? Who is that? The incident is really messed up. But all it's doing is raising more questions. The mystery just keeps piling up. Still can't go downstairs.
Nope. Ah, yes, to the ice room.
Raw.
They make sure everything they make is raw.
Biolab.
There's a Monokuma in here.
What the hell is with this room? It's freaking cold in here. It's like I'm in a freezer or something. If I just stand still, I might end up freezing to death. I should hurry up and investigate so I can get out of here already. There's... Aha!
Well played. Yes, you have. Yes, you did, Brad. Never actually seen that movie.
There's another manga just laying around here. This time, the title is Manga for Morons, the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. I knew it. The next one would obviously be about this incident. The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history, huh? Just what the heck was that incident really all about? It might turn out to be something lame. I flipped through the pages of the manga and hoped that I was right.
So I keep finding more of the nice ripoff of the scream image. Please don't be something bad.
Story about creepily drawn characters who get involved in such horrifying incidents. An incident known as the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. Is this drawn so grotesquely because the incident itself is that grotesque? Anyway, the beginning of this creepy manga starts with this sentence. The tragedy of Host Peak Academy was simply the trigger. At first, the uprising by the Reserve Corps students that triggered the tragedy of Host Peak Academy was initially hoped to be resolved quickly, but the situation continued to escalate to dangerous extremes. The movement started spreading all over the internet and fostered a thriving online community. The community was not limited to students, and people of various races and nations began joining in. But the moment was not confined to the internet. The movement was not confined to the internet, and it began spreading and eroding the real world. When the movement started, it was indistinguishable from any other demonstration inspired by social unrest. But as it spread across the world, certain abnormalities soon came to light. By then, it was too late. The end and the means had vanished, and the wanton destruction became their only goal.
Why'd you say it that way? Now I want wontons.
Wonton.
Damn it!
TX. The strong butchered the weak. The weak killed the weakest among them. And soon, the weak formed factions to brutally murder the strong. As the violence and death continued to spread, the shock of their actions began to disappear. As if the era was progressing to more uncivilized times when senseless deaths were the norm.
Cyberpunk.
Yes. I could have stopped reading, but I decided to keep going. The media was oversaturated with deaths to the point where people would watch them while enjoying a meal. By the time the world realized what it had become, it was too late to stop what had happened. A feeling of immense despair began spreading and eventually engulfed the world. Acts of terrorism, a coup de grace began occurring around the world, a war waged in the name of despair. A war fought not for principles, religion, or personal gain. Just war. Pure war. And because of that, there was no way to resolve it. How could a movement started by high school students progress to such a hopeless scenario? The only explanation is the existence of a certain organization devoted to a certain student who influenced Hope's Peak Academy. A group called Ultimate Despair. Instead of using Hope's Peak Academy's talents for the sake of mankind's hope, they use them for the sake of mankind's despair. Key members of society use their influence to brainwash the masses in order to spread despair. Tech-savvy computer programmers wrote software to spread despair. Powerful and influential created new values and morals to spread despair. With this, they created the tragedy, the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. As long as ultimate despair exists, the despair engulfing the world will never end. The tragedy will never end. My heart was racing in my chest. My body felt ice cold. And it wasn't because I was freezing in this room.
I was about to say, it's probably because you're in a fucking freezer room.
Yeah, you could have picked the book up and taken it outside.
Nah.
The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. This is definitely all made up. I mean, if this really is true, what's happening in the outside world? My family, my friends, the convenience store I frequent, the nearby bookstore, my favorite restaurant. What's happened to them?
No way!
Hey, are you seriously yelling at manga? How crazy are you?
Who would enjoy reading something like this?
What?
Oh my, you don't like the manga? A high school student who doesn't like manga is like an office lady who doesn't like to eat candy.
Enough. What is this messed up manga?
I thought you'd obviously know about such a horrible event that destroyed the world, but for you not to remember that, such despair. The Future Foundation's fault, though. Thanks to them stealing your school memories, the incident that happened during that period has been completely removed from your brains.
This incident really happened? And I actually forgot about it? There's no way that's possible.
What are you saying?
How many times do I have to tell you? All the clues here are real. Please understand, I'm rooting for you. If you learn about the full extent of the outside world, you guys will suffer for it. If you don't learn about the full extent of the outside world, you guys will suffer for it. I just want to help you guys so you can live a well-adjusted lives in the outside world.
Bye, Monokuma.
See, so that's how it is. That's what he meant by he wants to... That's what he meant by what he said at the beginning.
Yep.
Many important things were said.
He's trying to make us feel despair towards the outside world, so we'll want to stay on this island.
God, the tarps are still in this room. But the bottom half was warm.
The top half is frozen. But there's no way I'm going to do what he wants. A spirit like this simply can't exist. The outside world still should... The outside world should still be filled with hope. Just like now. Perhaps... No, that's definitely it.
Truth blitz.
Whether or not this incident really happened, what in the world is the ultimate despair group? They're devoted to a certain student who guided host the academy to its destruction. Are they connected to both the tragedy and the tragedy of Hope Speak Academy? Oh, I'm so tired, I don't know why. Plus, that organization isn't just one person, but a group of people. But if they're known as the ultimate despair, they're high school students, right? Well, they were actually able to do it, and I guess that's why they're called ultimates. Then, are the killings we're involved in connected to them as well? It's no use. I'm going to freeze to death. I'm at my limit. I need to get out of here. Shivering, I ran out of the freezer. Phew, that was close. We froze to death. No, you didn't.
You big baby.
So where should I go next?
Sounds like me.
Looks as though I can go to the fourth floor now. Nope. Did this door open up?
Well, I'm gonna find out.
5B. Ah. No, I should ignore it. I'm just going to pretend I didn't see him. Well, I want to talk to Monokuma.
Why, hello, Hajime. I hope you're doing pleasingly well. Are you pleasingly well? You're pleasingly well, right?
What are you doing here?
No.
Well, there was another thing I needed to tell you on this floor. I got bored of drawing manga. Can you forgive me for telling you by word of mouth?
You should have done that from the beginning. You didn't want to read your manga in the first place.
A high school student who doesn't like manga is like a sumo wrestler who doesn't like eating hot pots.
I'm getting really fed up with your babbling. Hurry up. What did you need to tell me?
It's about the key piece of information you've been wanting so long for.
What?
Surprise! It's about ultimate despair.
Hooray!
Huh? I have to tell this whole story in Monokuma's voice.
Yep. This is a great day to be me.
Yeah, I bet.
He just gave me the dirtiest look.
Ahem. Even though the term Ultimate Despair refers to a group these days,
absolutely,
it was originally the title for a high school girl who was the most powerful, evil, and fearsome person alive.
A high school girl?
Yes, indeed.
Lady Junko Inoshima.
Junko Inoshima?
Hey.
As for the former Ultimate Despair, she created a despair brimming with charm and humor, and created the Ultimate Despairs. There was one really horrible person in that group.
Don't talk with me.
Hold on a sec. I don't know what the Ultimate Despairs are, but it's not that easy to form an organization. There's no way people would just join some fucked up organization created by a high school girl.
Yeah, that's what they said about Hitler too.
Yeah.
Humans who are obsessed with their philosophy have an uncanny power to attract others. It's a trait shared by many famous leaders throughout history, right? There's nothing strange about it.
See, like I said, Hitler.
Yep. That holds true for Lady Junko. With certain charismatic ability to attract people, she even influenced those in the highest echelons of power. Her connections were the main reason that incident became the tragedy in the first place.
So she even recruited people who would have been in a position to neutralize the threat. What happened to their purpose?
What?
Like I said, Why did they cause that incident? It doesn't even make sense. They had a purpose, right? There's no way they do that. They do what they did without any purpose.
Hey, okay.
It was Junko Inoshima's despair. Huh? For Junko Inoshima, despair isn't a purpose. It's a set of principles, a way of life, or an instinct. Despair is what defines Junko Inoshima as Junko Inoshima. What are you saying? It's a stuffed plushie. Hajime is a human, and it's exactly like that. What? Oh, I'm a stuffed plushie. Hajime is a human. It's exactly like that. Junko Inoshima is full of so much despair that she's truly helpless. Living, dying, eating, loving, for her, everything is despair. What the hell? With their overwhelming force of personality, Junko recruited the ultimate despairs one by one. She controlled their despair by taking advantage of their love, hate, grudges, anything really. Junko's despair is far more dreadful than any other. That idea had been slammed right into their minds. And so the ultimate despairs who had been recruited became nothing more than Junko's limbs. All despair, whether it was their own or anyone else's, was dedicated to Junko Inoshima. Like believers making offerings to their god. Like a mother providing food to her child. They dedicated all despair so they could escape from despair. All in Junko Inoshima's name. For example, they killed their families and friends and even destroyed their bodies through relentless mutilation. And to hopelessly top it off, they completely believed it was something that they had to do. There's no way something that crazy is possible. Do you know about the final days of the reserve corps students during the tragedy of Hope's Peak Academy? Final days?
In other words,
Junko had the power to change people's values. That is also true of famous people throughout history. Hey, what do you mean, final days? What happened to the reserve department?
Of course!
They fulfilled their roles as disposable limbs. They had believed in what they needed to. And so, the 2,357 students of the reserve department all committed mass suicide. Mass suicide?
What'd you say?
All 2,357 students? Oops, it wasn't all of them. One person was excluded. One person was excluded, huh?
Gee, I wonder who that could have been.
I don't believe it. There's no way I can believe this. Ultimate despair, Junko Inoshima. Hey, it doesn't scare me at all. I mean,
Bastard.
Junko Inoshima is already dead. Huh? Ultimate despair. Reserve department.
Ooh.
Hey, Fuyuhiko, it's me. Hey, Fuyuhiko, is it true what you said? Junko Inoshima is really dead?
Huh?
What? You didn't see? There was a book called Manga for Morons, Killing School Life in That Bloody Classroom. Bloody Classroom? No, wait. What was that you said about the killing school life? Like the killings were involved in. They were killings that happened at Hope's Peak Academy. As I recall, Mastermind took her own life because the remaining students worked together to defeat her. Yeah, that's what it was. The killing school life ended up failing in the end. As a result, 6 students who survived managed to escape from the academy.
Hey.
For a manga about the killing school life, it was drawn with lots of silly images and dumb gags. According to that, the mastermind behind the failed killing school life was Junko Inoshima. The mastermind took her own life? Which means Junko Inoshima is dead.
Like...
Turns out the killing school life was part of that whole biggest, most awful whatever incident. Junko took away the memories of former students of Hope's Peak Academy and forced them to kill each other. Former students of Hope's Peak Academy. She took away the memories, it's just like us. Apparently the whole thing was being filmed by surveillance cameras and broadcast worldwide. That's a limit. There's a limit to being cool, asshole. The surveillance cameras were broadcasting the whole thing?
No.
The students of Hope's Peak Academy are widely known as symbols of hope. Forcing people to watch the symbols of hope kill each other for the sake of survival. They were trying to fill everyone who watched the broadcast with despair all at once. That's messed up. but that messed up plan was stopped. Junko Inoshima failed. Junko lost to the students she placed in her trap, and after being overcome by despair she created, she took her own life. Dead Junko is no more. No matter how horrible she was, there's no reason to fear someone who's dead. Whether Monokuma's story is true or not doesn't matter. Junko Inoshima isn't alive anymore. Then, who is our enemy? If Junko Inoshima is already dead, are the rest of the Ultimate Despairs behind this? Are the followers of Junko carrying out her will? That's the only thing I can think of. I mean, the killings we're involved in resemble the killing school life. Well, I don't know who the hell is imitating Junko and making us go through this, but an imitation is just that, an imitation.
No shit!
If the students from Hunksby Academy stop the real deal, there's no way we'll lose to some fake. This is really an imitation. Are those surveillance cameras the same too? Cameras all over Jabberwock Island. Are they broadcasting somewhere, just like the surveillance cameras during the Killing School Life? Killing School Life. Ultimate Despair.
Man, Hajime, you totally know about that story, huh?
Well, what? Do you have a problem with that?
Well, I really wanted you to read the manga version since I took the time to draw it.
What are you gonna do?
Oh well, I'll just raise the flag.
Flag? What do you mean, raise the flag? What's going to happen to you if you do that?
One step at a time, and you're getting closer to clearing my character route.
Not making any sense.
Nailed it! I'll give you guys my all. I'll tell you everything I know, including information on the outside and the inside. Yeah! I'll raise them flags like crazy.
Cool.
Onward.
Huh? It changed to a different hallway again. It's so sudden. What's going to make something like this happen? No, I've already decided that I'm not going to be surprised. That's right. There's no time for me to be surprised by something like this.
I don't think you get a choice in whether you're surprised or not.
Closed. Hoping. This is the fourth floor then.
Correct. Music room.
What? This looks like the music room. I feel like I could see something strange. Yeah, that. Hologram. What is this? The words are floating in the air. This is like a hologram, right? Floating letters are forming a sentence. It looks like a passage from an email.
I'll read the email stuff, since you've been reading a lot. Regarding the report we gave you the other day, we have obtained information. A person who claims to be a survivor of Hope's Peak Academy. Upon further investigation, there are a total of 15 survivors. You may be wondering about the number of people at this time. If they're survivors of Hope's Peak Academy, it's possible they may be targeted by Ultimate Despair. We believe we should acquire them and place them in our care as soon as possible. Though I don't believe the group can go that far without Junko Inoshima rallying them. In a worst-case scenario, we must prevent a repeat of the Killing School Life. Also, if they are survivors of Hope's Peak Academy, we should expect them to be quite valuable to us. However, we are still investigating the details of their origins, and we have not located them either. We will continue investigating this matter. Also, regarding a separate matter, we have received a report from the research facility on Jabberwock Island. Preparations have been completed. It seems we can proceed with the experiment phase of the Neo World Program.
Survivors of Oak Peak Academy. 15 students? Is that about us? Excluding Chiaki, who was part of the Future Foundation. There were definitely 15 of us, but what does survivors mean? It's like they're talking from some other world. What happened outside Jabberwock Island? If the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history is really true, then the world isn't normal anymore. Maybe. I'm starting to feel like we might be better off not remembering the memories we've lost. looks like it's some sort of monument. Why would there be a monument in the music room? It's not just that. The mark engraved into the monument is the symbol of the Future Foundation, right? Below that symbol, there's a short passage engraved. To combat the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history, the graduates of Hope's Peak Academy were among the many who established the Future Foundation. Huh? The Future Foundation was established by the graduates of Hope's Peak Academy? Aren't they known as Rollbender? This is completely different. Monokuma had completely made it up. The Future Foundation's origins have been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. I guess that's all the clues in this room. It's finally confirmed. Future Foundation is on our side, at least. They were founded by the graduates of Hope's Peak Academy, and they took us in to protect us. But if that's true, Chiaki should have made that clear to us. Now, as long as Monokuma was around, she probably couldn't say anything carelessly. Monokuma, if he's the Future Foundation's enemy, then his true identity must be the ultimate despairs who caused the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. The ones who are carrying out the will of Jinko Inoshima are making us go through this. Also, this caught my attention in the email, too. What is this research facility on Jabberwock Island mentioned in the email? What's that about? The only Future Foundation facility we found on this ancient ruin was... There's no way that's the research facility. If there really is a research facility on this island, there should be other Future Foundation members here. But somehow, there are still so many mysteries. This feels different from classroom. Yeah, I just touched the cord.
Aha!
Let me make sure I didn't screw it up.
Okay, I mean, we're still here. I was going to say, I could also find out, but that works too.
It's probably the office, right? I mean, this room kind of has that stuffy teacher vibe to it. The office, huh? Now that you mention it, it does look like that.
There's some pixelated-ass flowers, too.
Yeah, no kidding. We're running out of storage, so they just grab some, like, 8-bit flowers.
Yep. That'd be a good name for an electronic-based band. 8-Bit Flowers.
Yeah.
Like the Sex Bombs.
More importantly, have you seen Miss Sonya? I don't see her anywhere. How much longer is this guy gonna be obsessed with Sonya? Give it up already.
There may or may not be a Monokuma in here, by the way. I don't remember.
May or may not.
I honestly don't remember. I remember the first year. Oh, no, there is one here. Cool. I'm glad I remember correctly.
Huh? Are you
serious?
Are you serious? Yes, I am.
Why so
serious? That looks like someone we know. There's something written on the blackboard. What's written here? List of subjects. List of subjects is written on the blackboard in large letters. Just below that, are names I've seen before.
The Ultimate Imposter, my favorite subject.
Yay.
Gundam.
She looks older in that picture. And every other depiction of her, she looks like she's 12 years old.
And I think 12 being a bit generous. I was going to say like 10.
There's a newspaper posted on the blackboard. Below that, Hyoko Sionji is written there. What is this newspaper?
She also looks a lot less mean.
Yeah. What is this? It says Miss Hyoko Sionji. This can't mean the same Hyoko, right? I mean, the Hyoko we knew.
The baby.
Yeah. She was much smaller and looked more childlike. It was pretty much her defining feature.
Well, that and her nasty attitude.
Yeah. But the photo in this newspaper, in a way, I can see the resemblance to Hyoko. But her height and figure, it's too different from the Hyoko we knew.
Hyoko didn't have boobs.
I like that it's like trying to say everything, but it's like, wow, it's a child versus like a grown, like a actual ass lady. It's Like, he's trying to be, like, weirdly diplomatic, but no one cares.
Yeah.
And she's only got one ponytail.
Oh, my God.
Bum.
What does this mean? That lady looks pretty mature. Is she Hiyoko's older sister or something? No, it says Hiyoko Seonji right here. Oh, then Hiyoko has an older sister with the same first name and last name.
What?
An older sister with the same first name and last name?
I mean,
that's the only explanation, right? I mean, look at it for yourself. That's not Hiyoko. But did you even hear her mention an older sister? Well, it's not like she was that close to... It's not like I was that close to her or anything. She doesn't have an older sister. Hiyoko is the Seonji family's only daughter. If she doesn't have a sister, then a relative? No. No, there's still too much of a resemblance.
What are you saying?
That's Hiyoko. Huh?
Of course not.
But what are you saying? Hiyoko doesn't have a curvy body like that.
Really?
I mean, she was famous for her childlike figure. She got away with all kinds of crap for looking like that.
Well...
I don't know what to tell you. Maybe she had a growth spurt. What are you saying? She's already dead. There's no way she could have had a growth spurt.
Maybe a blood spurt, though.
Today, I'm feeling white.
What? That's racist, Monokuma.
Oh, man.
I like what they did there, though, because he turns so you can see more of the white part of his body.
Yeah. Well, regardless, all the clues I provided are true. If there weren't, it wouldn't be fair.
What's going on?
What the heck? This is the truth? If this is the truth, then Hiyoko is in the newspaper. Is he really saying this is the same person? That's impossible. I mean, how can there be a photo of a grown-up Hiyoko when she's already dead? Why? Why does this even exist?
Hey!
Could it be related to the list of subjects over there?
Huh?
If it says subjects, maybe it means there was some kind of experiment, right? Did that experiment change Hiyoko's body?
Into the screen.
Yeah. What am I saying? Just saying it out loud makes it sound messed up. What experiment? If it's some kind of experiment, it would mean that we're also test subjects, right? I mean, our names are also written on the blackboard under that list of subjects. But what kind of experiment was it?
What's going on?
Yeah, what's going on? It better not have anything to do with the time travel. Yeah, it better not. Still something that looks suspicious. This man! Who is this man?
Nice coat warmer.
Yeah. An extremely overwhelming portrait is hanging. I wouldn't call that extremely overwhelming.
Not really.
Yeah, it just looks like
it's everywhere. It's
dude.
So.
Yeah, it's so big.
You just look there and you're like, ugh!
I can't look away from it.
It's like twice the size of that average wall clock.
I'm tired of all these stuffy looking white guys.
I feel like I've seen it before. The name etched into the placard says, Speed Academy's founder, Izuru Kamakura. The founder of Hope Speak Academy, and this name, Izuru Kamakura.
The ultimate receding hairline.
Yeah. The ultimate old white guy.
Guess he's not a white guy, but he... That is, like, quintessential, like, white guy portrait.
Doesn't this clearly contradict the information I obtained earlier? Damn it, another mystery. Academy's founder has been added to the True Bullet Section handbook.
He's got, like, the same expression as, like, in Ghostbusters 2. That painting of the guy.
Yeah! God! I was like, that does look familiar. I was trying to picture it. Now, that's what it was. Holy shit.
There are letters floating in the air, like the music room from earlier. It's a passage from an email someone wrote. I think it's the same one from earlier. I guess I should read it.
Yay.
Fun.
We understand this matter regarding the survivors. In order to safely acquire them, please do your best and continue your investigation. However, you must exercise extreme caution concerning the remnants of despair. Even though they have lost Junko and Ashima, the fact remains that they are incredibly dangerous. Even after her death, the tragedy has not ended. Perhaps there is still a leader on par with Junko Inoshima. As long as we do nothing about the remnants of despair, we will not be able to end this incident. For this reason, the remnants of despair must be immediately eliminated once they are discovered. Everything is for the sake of a shining future.
Immediately eliminated? Does that mean this is in order to kill them? That doesn't sound peaceful at all. Well, I guess that's understandable. The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history is as terrible as it sounds. It's pretty much all out war. If the remnants of despair are the ones waging that war, there's no way they'd be forgiven that easily. Despair.
Team Purple all the way.
Okay, with this, you totally raised all the flags on this floor. Congratulations, Hajime! You shall now go on to the next stage.
Hooray!
Next stage.
But I don't wanna.
Too bad, third floor.
Ooh, I'm on this floor.
Damn it, not again.
Always different from last time. I guess when that flag Monokuma mentioned is raised, I moved to a different hallway than the last. But how can he do that? No, now is not the time to come. Now is not the time to be confused by that. Think about it, just going to waste my energy.
I actually kind of like the cyber camouflage wallpaper.
It's kind of neat. I remember this floor. This is where Sakura died.
May she be forever remembered.
There's a billiard table, a dartboard, and a shelf lined with magazines. It's hard to think a room like this actually existed inside a school.
I didn't know that schools came equipped with floating pool tables.
Fire one shot and see what breaks first when it inevitably flies around the room and hits something.
It's a file with Hope's Peak Academy seal on it. It says confidential. That means this is a big secret, right? Why would an important document be here? I'm not even asking a question like that. Obviously, Monokuma is responsible. Anyway, I need to confirm what's inside the file. About the Hope Cultivation Plan. For many years, Hope's Peak Academy has conducted a rigorous research into various talents. The Hope Cultivation Plan seems to use the fruit of our labor to further our true goal. Let's say future. Everything's just future. With our future hands, we will future birth the true future hope that will bring hope to the future entire future world.
Future.
Truly, the future program is the next future innovation in providing the ultimate future education.
It actually worked really well there.
This future plan has been the Future Academy's wish since its foundation. So we must succeed at all costs, future. What followed was a series of future detailed instructions and future intricate orders. It was future full of difficult future technical terms, and I future had no idea what future any of them future meant.
It was future full. It's not full now, but give us some time. It'll be full later.
I mean, the book was empty, but I'm sure it'll be full of stuff, important stuff later.
Just pull out for your evidence. Wait a minute, all this wasn't here earlier.
Future, however, the world, true hope, future left a strong future impression on my future mind for some future reason. The future hope cultivation. Future, said the two words at the same time. The hope cultivation plan was created for the sake of birthing future true hope.
No, that's actually justice, true hope. Sparkling yes. Justice.
Hope's Peak Academy was behind something like that? I don't really future get it, but. There's something about these future words. True hope, future, huh?
Future hologram.
Yeah, let's say future hologram, you know? This future hologram again. What's this one future say? Your future looks like another future email in the passage.
Alright. Regarding the report we gave you the future other day, we have finally future succeeded in acquiring them and have placed them in our future care. Though they were all future dispersed, we were successful in acquiring all future 15 of them. due to the fact that we're unable to future ask them about specific future details, it is unknown how they managed to future survive the tragedy. It's been reported that future some are wounded, so it seems certain that they survived under future harsh conditions.
Didn't even catch you were doing that.
Really? Just, oh my god.
So many times I just looked at it and was like, how's that saying future?
Over the course of our detailed investigation, we determined that they are the same age as the others. So we've decided to entrust them to the survivors of the killing school life. As for the remnants of despair, there are still no solid leads regarding this matter, and we have no new information to report. We will continue with the investigation in the future. Once they are discovered, we shall eliminate them immediately.
In the future. We'll eliminate them future immediately.
Love the Future Foundation. Everything, oh, well there you go. Everything is for the sake of a future filled with hope.
Remnants of despair. Academy survivors. It says here they succeeded in acquiring them and have placed them in our care. That means we should have been protected by the Future Foundation, right? Then why is this happening? If the Future Foundation was protecting us, why were we forced to kill each other on this island? Well, I guess it's not possible that the Future Foundation set this all up.
What's this? My, Hajime, if you keep worrying like that, you're gonna get a toothache and collapse!
It's your fault. What is this hologram thing anyway?
Hey, it's exactly what it looks like. They're the Future Foundation's emails. I thought they made the perfect clue, so I did a little bit of hacking here and there and got them.
You can do that? Whoever's controlling you seems to possess many talents.
No!
Well, who cares about me anyway? That's not important at all.
I care about you, Monokuma.
Yeah, we care. There's no way that's not important. His true identity should connect everything to what's happening right now. Future
Monokuma.
Future leader?
To the future floor?
Ah!
Oh, what a feeling.
Looks like I'm in a different hallway again. Pretty much used to it by now, but even so. What is this space? Am I dreaming or something? I mean, this is just totally disconnected from reality. I don't like it. I don't like it, Derek.
Well, too bad. The old Byaku is just in there in a chair upside down reading.
Get out.
Get out!
This must be the library. Monokuma probably left something here too. I should hurry up and find it.
Oh, the music! I just love retro music. Not a lie.
This hologram again. Must be another one of the Future Foundation's emails. I should future read it. There's no future doubt that this is another future clue.
To Future Foundation, 14th Future Division, Makoto Naigi. Where are you guys? What are you doing right now? What you're doing is a serious act of treason. Do you understand? Why are you protecting the remnants of despair? It should be abundantly clear to you how dangerous it is to keep those people alive. Stay calm and think about this carefully. You guys are being lied to. Think carefully about what's important to bring the light of hope to the world. Think carefully about how the six of you joined the Future Foundation because you agreed with our ideals, right? Think carefully about how the Future Foundation rescued you from the tragedy you survived and cooperated with recovering your memories. Immediately return the remnants of despair to our headquarters. Unless we eliminate them, the tragedy will never end. Everything is for the sake of a future filled with hope. Future.
What does this future mean? This future email suggests that someone was future trying to let the future remnants of future despair future escape. This future email is addressed to Makoto Naegi.
His middle name is Future, conveniently enough.
But he's with the Future Foundation, right? Then, why was he trying to protect the remnants of despair? Did he future betray the Future Foundation?
What if he knew in the future that the top half was dry?
Oh my god, that would make just so much sense.
I think the universe would explode if that happened.
Remnants of despair.
He comes back to help the remnants of despair and sees the tarp. Oh no!
My one weakness. Half-wet tarps.
It's a pretty shitty weakness.
So specific, they'll never guess.
Granted, it would not come up in life very often, but when it does, you're in trouble.
I mean, if a tarp gets wet, pretty much it's half gonna get wet.
Yeah, like it's, that's the it's purpose its of job a tarp. Is to block water, yeah.
This wasn't here.
This was not
future here.
No, it wasn't.
Didn't I walk into a classroom? I don't really get it, but this looks like the laundry room. There's no use worrying about it, but I was in a school and now I'm suddenly in a laundry room.
Though to be fair, the pool legit was on the second floor in the original game, so.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, it was. Subtle.
Oh yeah, the pool was, huh?
Yeah.
No.
No.
I think you're only missing one of them now.
Sweet.
Future. Sorry, I heard my dad yell hope.
Future. This looks like a tablet computer. Looks like the power is on too. Is this the next clue? I picked up the tablet and immediately started examining it.
Take one tablet and call him in the morning.
I immediately threw it across the room as it was full of feet porn.
Ew. Nope. Stop.
Stop. Neo World program? The word Neo World. I seem to recall hearing it and seeing it a few times already.
Glad you have some level of memory.
Yeah. The Neo World program has another name. The Psychotherapeutic Communication Simulator. The Neo World program is built with the most recent psychotherapy technology and administrative software. To develop the Neo World program, individuals such as the Ultimate Programmer and the Ultimate Neurologist and the Ultimate Therapist were among many of the talented people whose research results were utilized. Mounting a device to the cranium, the Neo World program allows subjects to experience synthetic virtual world.
Who would be the higher paid, the ultimate, dang it, what was that first one?
Programmer?
The ultimate programmer or the ultimate neurologist?
I don't know. Additionally, the Neo World program has another feature. It can replace memories formed in the real world with information contained in the synthetic virtual world. Therefore, it is possible to undo trauma sustained in the real world through the use of the virtual world. However, the device is for psychotherapeutic purposes only, and other use is expressly forbidden.
Which is why it's probably being employed right now.
Yay.
Though it is highly effective in treating brainwashing, and abusing the device risks total personality destruction. Thus, extreme care must be exercised when operating this program.
That's why people are worried about doing that kind of thing in real life, to help people that have gone through, like, PTSD and other stuff like that.
Yeah. Slowly, everything around me turned black. Synthetic virtual world? Program? A feeling of emptiness, like everything is being tainted. A feeling of weakness, like the world is collapsing beneath my feet. Everything is starting to feel meaningless. The desperate attempts, the sad goodbyes, the conflicts, the trust I've felt until now. It's all disappearing until all I feel is the D, despair.
The D, the Lord of D.
The big sad.
The big sad.
I screamed loudly as if I was confirming the sound of my own voice.
I was hoping you'd do it again.
There's no way I can accept this. I am starting to accept that this. But that there's no way something as crazy as this actually exists. It's
nice. Man, if we had the time to do the third game, I'd love to see what you do with the ultimate robot character.
You gotta raise the flags. Yeah, you gotta raise the flags more in order to clear my character route. Now then, despair is waiting for you. Impossible. This is impossible. It's all made up. Everything. It's all made up. Made up. Including me, too? Leave here, yes.
Do you want me to read this? Or try to in a normal voice?
I mean, I think I can do it. Hey, how are you doing? Did you enjoy the killing school trip? By the way, do you guys remember the speech I made at the beginning? From this point on, I promise you a world that truly deserves to be called a game. What? You guys are the only ones watching this who can save them. The end of the world is nigh. What you gonna do? What's gonna happen?
isn't... What?
It.
It oh, it's like...
Yeah, the one is an I.
Isn't it... Oh. Isn't it exciting? Isn't it heart-throbbing? Look forward to it.
The sad thing is, that was probably one of the better Monokuma theaters for this game.
Yeah. This hallway. When we first arrived here, I walked down this hallway from the classroom to get to the gym. I don't really see a resemblance, but... Ah!
Yeah.
Ow!
Yeah.
That hurts!
Apologies to anybody who is sensitive to lights. You may not want to watch this. Oh, right. I forgot there are actual other characters that I need to voice. You went by Akane earlier, so I was like, all right, cool.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, you did. She was on, like, floor four, I think.
Oh.
I mean, it works for me.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with the placebo effect and the nocebo effect?
Huh?
The placebo effect is when your health improves after taking a fake medicine that you believe is real. And the nocebo effect is the exact opposite. Which means as long as the human brain controls all other bodily functions... If the brain believes something is real, it will become real.
Wait, is nocebo... What does she mean by nocebo? Is that just control?
That I think nocebo is taking something that's real and thinking it's fake so it doesn't do anything.
Oh, mm-hmm. I've never heard of that.
Yeah, no, that is an actual thing. It's typically a medicine thing, though.
Huh?
Eh?
Oh, my.
I am not sure. I do not fully understand... Is she a robot? Is she glitching too?
I do not fully understand. And.
And poof.
You!
Soldier boy up in this hole.
The moment you discovered the truth was a lie, all hope will disappear. Fuck off. Well... I don't know if this is more or less offensive than the actual wallpaper in this room.
Is this like the green, like, zebra print one?
Yeah,
I think that's
green
what
zebra
this one was.
One.
I mean, they were all pretty bad,
yeah.
To be fair. They were all quite horrible.
Yeah, they're me.
You should have seen the wallpaper that used to be in here before we painted it and then repainted it.
Yeah.
It was bad.
That's all I did. It's just a big floating thing in the room.
The obelisk. Even though that's not an obelisk at all.
Is this floating? That's impossible. There's no way something that big would be floating like this.
Not the first thing you've seen
in the world
floating,
is it?
Moron.
Sure. True. And the moment I looked at that object.
Woo!
Whee!
But...
T. Question.
Chihiro!
Oh, fuck.
Double
oh, no!
What did you do for that voice, Delta?
Just a really quiet one, I think.
Yeah.
Welcome. Because we thought she was a girl at first.
Yeah.
He was a girl at first. Welcome to the Neo World program.
A person?
Kind of.
A floating person is talking to me. Are you a wizard? Who is it? No, is this even a person in the first place? Are you a warlock?
Just backing up witchcraft!
yes, that wonderful Harry Potter movie where Hagrid killed Harry, cut him up, and then stuffed him into a frozen dessert. You're a blizzard, Harry. I'm not quite a person. I'm simply an artificial intelligence program.
That's sentient. Kind of a person.
Pretty much.
Morally a person.
It would make me happy if you called me Alter Ego. That is the name my master gave me when he created me.
It can talk? But what are you? Alter Ego? Artificial Intelligence Program?
Yeah, I just said that.
I am the master program created behind the Neo World program. I'm responsible for creating and overseeing this world. You're doing a bad job, my man.
I love the sound as his text loads in.
Yeah. A la Undertale, almost.
However,
only the Observer has the authority to directly influence you guys. I can't actually exert much influence. Ow. In fact, my existence is the one that you don't normally need. I'm sort of like a partner head or something. What? Okay.
I'm
just thinking to a partner.
sake of the world's timeline. I guess you can say it's appropriate for creating hope.
That virus.
I don't really know the details behind its true identity, but that function is beyond my capabilities. No matter how much I try and stop it, it behaves as if it already knows what I'm attempting to do. In the end, it stole the portion of my abilities which contain my authority to build the world. It was like a grandmaster chess player. Ah, yes, Guillermo Vila, everyone's favorite professional chess player. I desperately tried to fight back so it wouldn't have complete control. But even so, a portion of the world has been modified at its convenience.
She's probably talking about Monokuma Rock and the Funhouse. Based on what she's saying, it sounds like she's on the receiving end of a one-sided attack. Alter Ego should be an impressive artificial intelligence that the Future Foundation created. I can tell that just by communicating with her, which means the supposed virus is so smart that it surpasses this alter ego? If so, does that virus possess an artificial intelligence just like her? Damn it, what the heck? Artificial intelligence waging an attack against another one? That's so freaking cool! But how did the virus infect the Neo World program?
The Neo World program exists in isolation. It's impossible it was infected through a network. I'm fairly certain someone physically uploaded it.
Physically?
Perhaps someone secretly brought an external memory drive containing the virus into the facility and directly uploaded it into the main computer where the Neo World program is installed. Based on my calculations, that's most likely what happened.
It was brought to the Future Foundation's facility? But the only person who could enter the facility is someone who was a member of the Future Foundation. Damn it, what am I thinking?
Someone brought in herpes.
Why am I assuming that what I just heard is the truth? Why am I assuming that everything is a lie? Observers! Neo World.
Yeah. But it's true that the virus is powerful and that I'm completely overwhelmed by it, but I'm still able to defend the essential areas. So it has a limit, too.
A limit?
If it took over an observer, then it has to follow the rules of an observer. Such as, in order to end the program and release everyone, I need to follow the correct procedure and...
Okay, even if you're just a god in the machine, that's enough hints for you.
Deus Ex Machina.
If you're gonna say something more, suppose that you exist between life and death of yourself is inevitable. So, if so, it can be... Okay, you can stop freaking out again. It can be parallel to the deep fluctuation based on the definition of existence that constitutes the relationship. From there, that paradigm...
What is that? What was that music change?
A change results by being cut off rapidly and causes a situation where your own existence is unobservable and...
And two, maybe three, we're not sure.
Accelerates and crosses with the joint ownership of the world and the situation from the context invites your...
I feel like they were just reading out of a textbook for a minute there. So much death.
Okay.
Yep, that was the thing that happened.
Already? What the heck? What just happened? You're right there, aren't you? Someone is right there, right? Huh? Who are you? Are you different from the earlier one? Maybe he can't hear my voice from this side. I'm currently talking to the world through Alter Ego. Ever since you guys vanished into that space, the video's feedback has been pretty distorted. But even so, we were forced to watch you this entire time. The things you guys were forced to do, we were forced to watch it.
It's time for the long-awaited graduation exam. Please enter the red door located on the first floor of Hope Speak Academy. See you soon.
Thank you. Me off.
I can't ignore that.